On today, we are initiating a two-day process which is remarkable and historic in its implications for the use of international law as a means of addressing the crimes against oppressed people who do not have the benefit of state power and the use of national and international courts, which are traditionally only available to those groups who do possess state power. On today, we are